a smaller crowd today, and I almost feel like I should preach from the steps, but since there's 10,000 flowers up here on the pulpit, I have to come up into the pulpit and preach today. There's a beautiful calm around the world today after the rush of shopping and many of our celebrations have passed, and we're here just to sort of sit and let the reality of Christ's birth kind of sink into our senses and our understanding. The fever and rush to get ready has passed, and there's a peace and serenity about this occasion, this holy day that we observe today. All through our preparations for this holy season, we've been surrounded by sights and sounds and smells that tell us that Christmas is coming. Through the years, we've developed many symbols to remind us of our Savior's birth. We appreciate many of those sights and sounds today. Our church is absolutely beautiful, just filled with flowers. Everywhere you look, almost there's flowers. And Joseph Golden's amazing skills can make us feel like there's 500 people singing in this room as we fill it, this house of God, with just absolutely. One of my favorite things that I always associate with Christmas, and I see it, hear it every year, and it always just kind of stays with me, is that sound of the bell ringer for the Salvation Army. Now, I don't know if you've ever really just kind of paid attention to that or not. Sometimes that single person ringing a little bell can get lost in the shuffle, but I always love to see that person and to hear that beautiful, simple sound, the bell ringer for the Salvation Army. Every time I go to the Piggly Wiggly, I pay attention to that person and that thought. The bell sound kind of stays with me. It's beautiful. It's familiar to me. I like thinking about that particular bell ringer. This person stands amid the chaos and the rush of the crowds, ringing with a steady beat this beautiful little brass bell. And the sound of the bell, for me, symbolizes two things. First, the bell announces the joy of our Savior's birth. With beauty and clarity, the sound rings out amidst the chaos of this world, people not really paying attention to what's going on, reminding us, calling us to pay attention that this season is about something very special. The bell is also a call for us to realize the significance of what God has done in sending Jesus Christ to be born for us. The long-awaited Savior of the world has appeared. The one who would save us from sin and death has taken on flesh and become one of us and lived among us. Secondly, the bell rings out to call our attention to the needs of others who are less fortunate than us. The bell tone, the bell ringing, is a plea for us to search our hearts and find ways to give the gift of our own love to a hurting world. The Salvation Army bell ringer reminds us both of the joy of the Savior's birth and the pain of many around us in need. The bell reminds us of our hopes and our fears. It's so much easier for us to focus on our fears, isn't it? Most of us have much to be fearful about. As a people, we are fearful about the realities of our world, the threat of war, the lack of peace in the world, financial concerns. We are fearful about our government, what might happen in the years to come, the political tension that we live in, the strife and stress of our own family lives we are worried about. So many fears creep into our lives. Threaten our happiness. But this little Christmas bell that rings continually with a steady beat reminds us of our hopes and our fears, and the beautiful truth that this day shares with us is how our hopes and our fears are related. The gift of the Christ child to the world means that joy has entered the world in the birth of a child sent from God that brings hope and joy to the whole world. And that joy has redeemed all of the suffering and trouble that this world has known and will know in years to come. The bell rings to remind us that we have been blessed by a God who loves us so much that he entered this world of sin to redeem us and make us his own forever. When we realize the magnitude of this gift, we want to reach out to those around us in need. Christmas is here, and it's our turn to ring the bell. Our lives should be heralds of joy for what God has done for us. And our lives should be a sound to the world that Christ's love calls us all to share the same love that we have been given. John's beautiful gospel that we hear in our worship today tells us the good news of Christmas. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. And we have beheld his glory. From his fullness we have all received grace grace. God's gift of grace is given to us at Christmas in the birth of a Savior. By God's grace and God's gift, our hopes and fears are met together. May the love of Christ this Christmas cause your hearts to overflow, and may your lives be like a bell ringing out in generosity, thanksgiving, and praise for all the blessings that God has given.